G'day everybody, welcome back to our playthrough of Dinkum. I can't remember what episode it is, sorry guys. Again, it's been one of those, episodes where I haven't been playing for a while, on account of this cold and trying to shake it off. So, there's been a lot of sleeping in between. But, anyway, if I'm not mistaken, in a previous episode, we did go into the deep mines and... Yeah, I don't know if you could say that it was a successful run. I mean, we did find a few Baconium ores here and there, but... probably just enough for one more bar, and that's about it. So... Yeah, we're gonna need to plan to try and get back into the Undergrove very soon, hopefully. Now, in this episode, you've probably noticed here, but we don't actually have any meat left for the doggos. So, this episode is probably something a little bit different, which is a whole bunch of hunting. We haven't exactly done hunting as an activity in this series for maybe a very long time. I found these floating in the river. I know you're always looking for this sort of stuff, so I sent it to you from Milburn. Cool. And something from Franklin here as well. I found this old key in the dirt the other day. I've seen these before. Do you know what they do? Absolutely, mate. I'll take those off your hands. And so we're gonna be doing a little bit of hunting today, which is a little bit of an unusual activity for us. I'll keep our spare sprinklers in here because that'll hopefully come in handy at some point. Got the bottle of clouds the other day as well, which is cool. I think these mighty seeds can just go here. We've got tons of stuff to sell to John. We definitely need to go see John today. So we'll get that done, definitely. Let's also get all of our farming done for the day. So one pumpkin here, still waiting on the rest. Looks like our kale is ready. Speaking of kale, I think yesterday I completely forgot to check in with Rain to see if she was selling some kale seeds. So we better actually check in today and see if we can buy some, because I have a feeling that we're gonna run out for the day. But we'll see how we go. Let's drop off some kwandongs. And yeah, just gonna see if I can grab the scythe. That should speed up the process of gathering those kale. Those kale leaves, or those bunches of kale. And we should actually get some fertilizer going. Okay, good stuff. Let's use our iron scythe here and do what we need to do. Let me just very quickly chuck our kwandong supply back, just so that we don't accidentally leave it at storage. Alright, very nice. Yeah, I really, really don't think we'll have enough kale seeds, to be honest, guys, so I'm not even gonna bother getting the kale seeds right now, until we have a visit to Rain's place. Alright, looking good. I think the only thing that we really need to do is grab the milk and the wool. And from there, we should be able to get the day started. I mean, we probably will have to just come back and, you know, replant the kale, though. So, all I need is these two. Yeah, poor doggos. They're probably a little bit hungry by now. Try and find some meat for them. Alright, and I think that can go there. Cool. I think we'll take the bike today, because we do need to sort of stick around ground level to try and, you know, get to those roos. But yeah, obviously not before we figure out what we can do with the kale. Hopefully we can buy some kale seeds today. Okay, let's start by maybe just dropping some of these things off. Get the flour going. And I'll quickly visit John's right now, just so we can quickly sell some of these things that we don't really need. Welcome to John's Goods, how can I help? Alright mate, you can have all of this stuff here. I am gonna sell the paint, because I don't really think we need the paint, to be honest. Yeah, I think that looks good. Let's see. All up, I can offer you 694,000 dink. Nice. It's a big wad of cash. Might need to go see Milburn again. Compost request. 3 days. We need one alpha antler for that. Okay, I didn't know you can make the fertilizer from alpha antlers. Is that even a thing? Alright. Well, maybe I should actually give it a go, because it's not like we're using the alpha antlers for anything. Although, I don't have an alpha hammer just yet, so I should perhaps actually get that whenever we see Ted next. Speaking of Ted, we haven't actually bumped into Ted in a very long time, I feel. Anyway, I think that can go there. Actually, no, we don't have any gumwood planks. And the jellies go there. Ah, yes, I totally forgot, but I'm not supposed to make any cheese. I'm supposed to save up the milk for, well, for other things that might need the milk. That goes there. Yeah, we're definitely running low on some of these tools. We should actually get a repair kit sometime soon. Actually, oh no, it's Saturday. We can't even get a repair kit today. That's what I need. Alright, just so we don't have to sort of worry about our kale situation, I'm gonna buy like something like that for now. We've got plenty of money as well, so we might as well. Let's also buy a mine pass. Very good. Alright, actually, sorry, let me just double back there. I thought I saw a repair kit here. Oh no, sorry, that's a wheelbarrow. My bad. Alright, let's drop this off over here, and yeah, maybe we'll try and go back to John and see if we can buy a few more mine passes, just so that we've got a little bit of a supply. Okay, are we ready for the day? I think we are. I'm going to go back and obviously plant the kale, but we also have the hunting to do, and yeah, just looking at what we can use to hunt here. I think the alphabets should last us for the day, and then we might have to think about repairing all of our tools after that. But, yeah, hopefully we get some decent amount of meat. I will actually address all of this right now, guys, because there's no point in us keeping all of this. Let's leave the dress. I want to try selling the blueprint if we can. Welcome to John's Goods. How can I help? I've got a ton of stuff for you, mate. I think that's it. Let's see how much we make from this. Let's see. All up, I can offer you 59,000. Okay, that's a far cry from what we sold him before. I wonder what the highest value items were that we sold to him before. So, I've never seen a dog hat before. Let's buy that. You know, that would look great on you, Blue. Excuse me. That'll be 8,800. Alright. Sure. Why not? We'll add it for the collection. I'm just gonna quickly check in if Clover needs anything. Do you need anything, Clover? I've got a real hankering for a bottle brush tea. Think you can bring me a bottle brush tea to eat? Well, I can bring it for you to drink. So, yes, sure. In fact, we are making some right now. I have no idea how long it will take to actually be ready. Actually, there it is. It is already ready. So, what I might do, guys, is I might actually drop one more batch just because we always sort of make batches of four. So, it'll be a little bit awkward. Oh, sorry, we need 10 for that. My bad. Yeah, it'd be a little bit awkward if we only made, like, three batches of the brew, considering we're giving one of the teas away, so... yeah, let's just give away this tea right now. And yeah, I suppose we should then get the day started by going back and replanting the kale. There you go. One fresh batch of bottle brush tea. Thank you very much, Blue. I'll put in a good word for your help. Oh, I found this, you know. You can take it because you helped me out. Camo dress. Okay. Not really my style, but that's okay. We'll leave that one for John as well. Okay. So let's head back. Grab the bike. And let's get a move on, because the meat isn't going to hunt itself. Yeah, I got to be a little bit careful about which tool I'm using to do the job here, because I definitely don't want to break my my battle shovel. Three bones in that? Okay, well, I guess the ruse in Muyan not eating very well, apparently. They're a bit bony. Alright. And plenty of coconuts as well. My lord, guys, I am getting super distracted, aren't I? Alright, let's not bother with the coconuts for now. Let's go back and let's do what we must at the farm. Now, one thing is we should actually feed the boys immediately since we've got a little bit of meat right now. There you go. Good boys. Alright. And from here, we should get all of the kale back in. All right, looks good. Actually, I missed a spot there. There we go. All right, very nice. And a little bit more over here. Oh, okay, we're missing some carrot over here for whatever reason. Did the birds get to it? Surely not. Maybe I accidentally took it out. I better get one carrot seed for that. But I think that's it, right? I don't think there's any more kale that needs to be replanted anywhere. So let's put our kale seeds away. Grab one carrot seed. And as soon as we're done with that, we should be able to get going. Yeah, I'm concerned about how late we're starting some of the other patches here. It is taking a while for us to wait for some of the pumpkins to mature, but yeah, I just don't want to have to fiddle around with, you know, making sure that the timing is correct for some of the other crops. Anyway, let's head back out. Now, along with hunting the ruse, I am going to also do some treasure hunting at the same time. Now, whether or not we sort of use the metal detector or we just look out for the X's in the ground is yet to be seen. Hopefully we find a few X's out and about and, you know, that'll make things a lot easier, but yeah, if we don't find too many, then I'm happy to just metal detect every now and then. I haven't seen a lot of roos though. And those are the only things that I really want to try and hunt. Although we could perhaps maybe hunt some of those bush devils as well, because the bush devils are, you know, a little bit of a menace. So, you know, we might be doing other species a bit of a not a flavor, a favor. Good stuff. Since we're out here, we might as well clear a few things at the spare house. Feels like maybe we haven't really been here in a while, so a good chance. Just trying to see if we can spot some more roos. Definitely a few right here. So let's see if we can get these guys. Alright. Very nice. How's the inventory looking? Okay, not so hot. Probably need to store stuff very soon, but that's okay. I think we can keep going. As long as we don't decide to sort of pick up a whole bunch of other stuff that we haven't picked up just yet. I'm definitely not up for hunting doggos though, guys. It's definitely not my style. So there's Ted. Well, Ted's whistle anyway. But I'm not entirely sure exactly where he is. Must be around here somewhere, though. Alright, very nice. Haven't really seen a lot of X's in the ground, guys, and we haven't exactly found any keys. So I might do a little bit of metal detecting right now, since we're sort of right next to the beach. Sorry about that, guys. Hopefully you can't really hear the hoons that are out tonight as well. It is a Sunday right now as I record this, and they're probably getting their final fix before they have to go back to work tomorrow. So that's fair. There must be a key in this one. Come on. Ah, what? Okay, no keys. Alright, maybe we'll check this one. Ah, there we go. Lucky. We don't have any space for anything else, unfortunately, so might be a good idea to head back, maybe very soon. We could continue our whole sort of hunting expedition, though. I don't see why we can't. We've got 10 meat at the moment. Definitely not nearly enough, if you ask me. I would like to have a much larger supply than that, so... Ah, there he is. Let's actually quickly check in with him. I know that he really likes... what was it, like... cooked prime meat or something like that? But anyway, let's have a chat. Ah, Blue! Always nice bumping into you. What can I do for you? Let's chat. Oh, what do you want to chat about? What's new? I never run away from a challenge, unless that challenge has big teeth and it's way too close. Let's also just quickly check if he's got something that he wants us to do, which isn't too hard. A cockroach, okay. Pine forests, sure. I mean, cockroaches are pretty much everywhere at night, right? So I don't think that's going to be too much of an issue. Let's just quickly mark down where he is here. Just so we can sort of get back to him. But what I might do is actually make our way back to the house. The primary house. The home. Alright. I feel a little bit weird about this particular intersection, guys. It feels like A, there's not a lot of light, and B, we don't have enough signs in this place pointing us the directions of where to go. Goodness me. This lizard. This lizard has just killed everything around here. I mean, if he's not going to eat all of the meat, I will take it. So, that's actually a big haul right there. I'm not going to bother with writing down the stuff for now. We'll come back to that and complete that process a little bit later. That's the Western Connection. Wuyan Town, over this way. I'm probably missing one more sign on this side as well. Do something like that. Alright. Yeah, not a bad day, actually, because we found a little bit of meat. So, definitely doing what we said that we were going to do. We probably don't need to stop here exactly, but I might as well take this opportunity to chuck the dog hat into our collection there, and we've got a bit of fertilizer here we can drop off here. as well. Some bones as well. Let's chuck that back there. And yeah, we'll make our way into the workshop. We'll drop stuff off there. And then we'll go back out. I want to try and grab a hold of the insect hook as well. That should actually help us with finding the cockroaches a little bit easier. But anyway, this is what we wanted to do primarily. Just drop all this stuff away. Apparently we've got some paint that I've forgotten to sell. It's fine. There we go, we're already at 16 keys, so I'm actually quite happy about that. 16 keys is actually a decent amount, right? To actually go into the deep mines and do some work finding some baconium. Ooh, speaking of baconium, that's one thing that I've forgotten to do for the day. We do need to smelt our baconium ores into one bar, so we'll come back for the bar. I'm sure no one here likes stealing baconium bars. I wonder if baconium might be radioactive, considering its slight glow and its ominous look. I would have thought it could have been radioactive. But I guess this is not that kind of game, right? Imagine if you were carrying the ores and it was just like slowly did damage to you. That would be painful to deal with. Alright, so let's grab our book. So, bug book. And let's keep that handy. Yeah, let's maybe just stop every now and then to check to see if we can find any cockroaches around. Brilliant. I didn't even need any effort whatsoever, guys. Alright, so cockroach in hand. Just need to go back and see Ted. I should actually check in and see how much things cost to actually make the hammer. I'm not entirely sure if I will actually get into making the hammer tonight though, because I still want to try and find as much meat as we can. And yeah, we'll still continue finding keys and stuff like that as well. Okay, if I'm not mistaken, he should be just around here. I think I keep saying this, but we do need to get into a little bit more mowing. Hey, mate.
What?
Ah, Blue. Always nice bumping into you. What can I do for you? Let's chat. This is for you, mate. One cockroach. Oh wow, can't believe how helpful you are. Take this, you've earned it. Orange shorts, okay. I don't think I have a pair of orange shorts. But anyway, let's quickly check in and see how much things cost to actually, sorry, that's the wrong choice right there. Oh no, I think I accidentally stored all of my meat in the storage at the workshop, so I'm gonna have to fetch a lot of that. Let's see what you can make. So battle shovels are 150,000 each. That's not too bad, actually. So one thing that we haven't actually played around with is the bone bow, which I'm guessing we would need bone arrows to go with it, but yeah, maybe one of these days we should get it and just play around with it. Then there's the alpha hammer, which we haven't gotten before. We certainly have enough opals, I feel, and we probably have a couple of alpha antlers, iron hammer we definitely have. So, yeah, this is definitely doable. Look, we might not do it today, but the next time we see Ted, we'll definitely commission, well, not really commission, we'll buy an alpha hammer off of him. Well, I suppose we're not really buying it off of him. He's basically gonna make it for us then and there, right? But yeah, that'll be cool. It'll be nice to sort of see what you can do with it. Again, sorry guys, those bloody hoons. I see meat around. Yes, thank you. All right. I feel bad though doing a bit of a hunting episode, because it feels like I'm just killing like heaps of wildlife, and you know, like, I don't like the thought of over hunting. Probably should get these turkeys as well, because I barely ever hunt the turkeys, I feel. Not too many in this area, actually, but maybe if we continue going north a little bit. Any scrub turkeys around here? Looks a tiny little bit weird here. I might actually just quickly fix this up while we're here. Yeah, so the scrub turkeys, I feel really, really sorry for, because they can't even, like, run very fast. At least the roos can get away. They're just sitting ducks. Alright, since we're here on the beach, we may as well. Hopefully we'll find like one or two more keys in this episode. That would be nice. But yeah, I'm also thinking about maybe doing another dredging episode where we go into the river to try and find some more goodies that way. I don't think that'd be a bad idea, considering we've done it for one of the rivers, but not the other one. So I'm sort of curious to see if we would have much luck in the other river as well. I'm sure it'll probably give us like similar results, to be honest, but you know, at the very least I want to say that we have done some river treasure hunting in the other river as well as the one that's closest to us. So okay, well, That wasn't very successful over there. Let's just see if there's anything else we can hunt around here. Yeah, our pockets are already full. Jeez. Alright. I thought I heard another one. Ah, there. I feel like I've wiped out its entire clan. Sorry, guys. Evil. Evil. We've turned evil in this episode, I feel. Alright. Let's head back on the bike. And yeah, it's already late, so I think I'm gonna head back. See if I can sort of store stuff first and then come back to the farm. I saw one more turkey there, but I think I'm gonna leave that one alone. He'll repopulate the area. At least that's what I'm telling myself. Responsible hunting. That's what we do around these parts. All right. Just spotted a couple of these things, so we may as well. Actually, we've not found a single key while we're out here this second time. We might have to maybe forego a few of these shells. Yes. Exactly what we're looking for. Alright. Well, in terms of what we're gonna do tomorrow, guys, I feel like we're probably already know that with this many keys in our possession, I think we should go back into the undergrowth and continue looking for that Burconium. Hopefully we have a better time than the last time. And look, it sounds like I'm complaining about the last time, but it wasn't a bad run. I just feel like we could have found a little bit more. Or maybe I'm just getting a little bit greedy. Alright, so I think I did make the mistake of chucking all of our sort of meats and stuff like that there. I am going to just grab... Maybe we should just halve that, because I do want some ingredients here, so we'll take 13 meat back with us. I think everything else is looking good. This probably just needs to go to John whenever he's sort of ready for it. Got our very valuable Burconium ores there. Sorry, Burconium bars. I'm just going to chuck that there. Hopefully by the end of the episode tomorrow, we will actually have enough Burconium to smelt 2 bars. And if we do, that means we've got enough bars to upgrade our first power tool. And yeah, I better actually check in with the comments. I haven't checked the comments for a while because I have been really unwell. But hopefully you guys have already, you know, put down some of your suggestions on what should be the first power tool that we upgrade. But if you haven't, definitely leave a comment under this video, because yeah, I would be very, very interested in your thoughts on what we should really be upgrading first. But anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this episode. I think we kicked the goals that we set out for ourselves, which is to find as much meat as possible for the two goodest boys, which are still playing out there somewhere. Ah, there they are. Walking back. Tails between their legs. Come on, boys. It is bedtime. Way past your bedtime. Get in there. Get. Get. That sort of worked out, didn't it? Anyway, guys, I am calling this episode. Hope you enjoyed it. Leave a like, a dislike, or a comment or two down below. Stay true, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.